yes, Sarah. You know, next year I'd like to go as Benedict Arnold.
Wait until you see what I've got planned for the fireworks show tonight.
Grover, don't interrupt while Sarah is interrupting.
And guess who volunteered to choose the music for the program?
I did, Pop. Listen to this.
Oh, that's a nice tune, Jimmy. You know, with our new Crosley radio set, we can get news and big-time entertainment from all over the country, even Pittsburgh.
People are starting to arrive downtown for our spectacular 4th of July parade and fireworks event tonight. Mayor Beerfield is about to...
Oh, Patricia!
Yes, Father?
Better get a move on. The radio says folks are arriving downtown.
Do I really have to go? If my new boyfriend Theodore sees me in this, it'll scare him away.
Well, dear, if that happens, you'll always have that torch you can carry for him.
Oh, Father.
Calm down, Rover. I was only kidding. By the way, we have indoor plumbing now. Oh, boy, that's really great on cold nights, especially for our perennial house guest, old Uncle Orville. Uncle Orville's taken over the coolest spot in the house, of course, and he's rigged up a real clever contraption. He calls it air cooling. Too bad he's not reading the Help Wanted ads.
No privacy at all around this place.
Sorry, Orville. You know, considering all
the... Oh, George, your costume's ready.
Oh, coming, Martha, as I was saying. Considering all the conveniences we now have, I'll say that we're really on Easy Street these days. It just can't get any better. Just goes to show that...
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come.
It's another Halloween here in the fabulous 40s. Everything is better than ever now, and we've got some amazing new wonders around the house to prove it. For instance, our refrigerator holds more food and ice cubes. And thanks to our automatic dishwasher, oh, I don't have to dry the dishes anymore after supper. Gives Rover and me more time to enjoy our evening stroll together. Later, boy. Oh, and here's something else that's new. I just heard a new term today on the radio. Fella says, we've got something now called the rat race. Did you ever hear that one? It sure describes my life. I'm involved in something now called commuting. I drive into the city for work all day and then turn right around and drive all the way back. And the highway is crowded with fellow rats doing the same thing.
That's what they call progress, dear.
Yeah, I guess she's right. But we do have television when it works. Gives you something to do after you come home. I kind of like it, you know? Guy named John Cameron Swayze gives us all the news. And then they have all this singing and dancing. A lot of fluff, but it's fun. You know, I predict the day when millions of people will learn Latin and Greek sitting in front of their TV sets.
Are you awake, dear? Shh, shh. Give him a left, you big lug.
Ah, yes, a new age of electronic civilization is upon us.
Hey, Dad, what do you think of my jack-o'-lantern?
Oh, boy, that's scary.
That's because I'm using my beautiful sister Patty's picture for a model.
Down, Rover. Jim, Rover appreciates your joke.
Now, you're always kidding poor Patty. She's certainly prettier than either of you.
You hear that? My daughter Patty is using that old exercise machine she rescued from the attic. It was all the rage in the 20s. Grandma, of course, had to have one. Didn't work then, doesn't work now. Consistent, at least. Makes a lot of noise and blows fuses.
As I was saying, Babs, I think college is really swell. You should give it a try.
Oh, Patty, are you going to the Halloween party tonight?
Oh, yes. And I'm hoping to lose a few more inches by then, since I'm going with that dream boy, Wilfred.
Wilfred? What a slug!
He's coming as the headless horseman.
It fits.
Come on, Babs. That clodhopper Howard you're going with is no ratchet eyes.
Oh, poor Howard. I wonder what they said about me when I was dating Sarah. You're lucky, Rover. You don't have to date. Well, we're caught up in the do-it-yourself craze these days. We're remodeling our basement in something called a rumpus room, and we're looking forward to a few rumpuses, I'll tell you, as long as they don't get out of hand.
John, this papering is getting out of hand. I could use a little help.
Now, Sarah, didn't I set up that clever automatic paint stirring machine for you?
Yes, John, you're a genius. Of course, this will ruin my food mixer. Not that you'd care.
Oh, good old Sarah. Always the last laugh. What happened, Sarah?
Oh, you and your progress. That paint mixer of yours just sloshed paint across my rump. A room.
Now, how do you like that? I always say if you're going to be married, marry a girl with a sense of humor. Well, it's time to move on. Let's cheer up Sarah by singing our song. Come on, everybody.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away.
Isn't it a pleasant holiday? Oh, turkey's in the oven, it's peaceful and quiet.
Yes! 300 points, my best score yet.
Well, it was peaceful until Santa brought that new virtual reality space pilot game.
Your turn, Grandma. Let's switch the image over to the TV so the resident flying ace can show you how it works. Now, it's a little tricky. Just use your game glove to fly behind the other guy and blast him with your laser blaster.
Laser blaster? Well, I'll give it a try.
Take a look around, Grandma. You're in the ship.
Feels like I'm really there.
Okay, get ready. You're about to blast off.
Here goes nothing. Whoa.
All right, here he comes. Oh, you missed him.
Hey, everybody. I'm done programming our new voice activation system.
Now all our household items will do anything we tell them to do.
Great. Tell the refrigerator to bring me a root beer.
Well, it can't quite do that. But I'll show you something it can do. Tree lights 30% brighter.
Ooh. Oh, that's no big deal. Anybody can do that voice-activated stuff. Watch this. Rover, speak!
John, the oven should respond to your voice commands now. Give it a try.
Oh, okay. Here goes. Temperature to 375.
Temperature increase to 375.
Look at that. It even talks back.
Reminds me of certain people I know.
Yeah, right, Dad.
You gotta lose them, Grandma. Bank to the right.
Remember Dad's turkey last year?
Yeah, that thing really smoked up the place when it burned, didn't it?
We ended up microwaving frozen pizzas.
Well, no need to worry about the turkey this year. Not with an oven that will do anything your father tells it to do.
Oh, good shot.
Did you see that?
Dad, Grandma's up to 550 points.
Did you say 550? Hey, she's getting the hang of that thing.
550.
I can't believe all the new gadgets they've got now. You know, in my day...
Oh, no. You're not going to tell us about the old days when you didn't even have a car phone.
Hey, Trish, for a while we didn't even have a house phone. Not to mention laser discs and high-def TV and everything is automated today, including... Well, including that.
No privacy at all around this place.
Sorry, Orville. Anyway, you guys don't know how good you got it nowadays.
You know, my grandpa told me the very same thing when I was a kid.
Take that, you nincompoop!
Hey, check it out, Dad. Grandma's up to 975 points.
Wow, 975?
Temperature increased to 975. Bake mode, overload. Command, error.
John, what's wrong with the oven?
What?
Bake mode complete. Enjoy your meal.
Anyone for pizza?
Oh, another Christmas turkey ruined.
Man, what a game. I really smoked those guys. Looks like I'm resident flying ace now.
Oh, best 2 out of 3, Grandma.
Later, kid. Boy, that was fun. What will they think of next?
Who knows? We've got a whole new century waiting for us out there.
Yeah, and maybe sometime in the new century, your father will learn how to talk to our oven.
Well, maybe by then ovens will read our minds. But hey, as long as we're all here and happy and together for the holidays, who cares if I burned our Christmas turkey?
I do. I'm starving.
Don't worry, Dad. Someday, everything's going to be so automated, you won't ever have to cook another Christmas turkey again.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away.
Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart.
And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true.
Thank you for joining us on Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress. We hope you've enjoyed this tribute to the 1964 Carousel of Progress from the New York World's Fair. Please gather all of your personal belongings and exit through the doors located at the back of the theater. Have a great big beautiful day. And remember, tomorrow is just a dream away.